St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King, a legacy of domination for 50 years. Go Fish Ontario, it's catching.
God. Another one. Wow. Man, oh man. Unbelievable, eh? You start seeing them on the sonar, you find the bait fish, you find the bass. Welcome back to Extreme Angler, folks. This week, look at that. You know what it's going to be? The best of both worlds. It's fall. The smallmouth are hungry. They want to eat. We're here. And you say to yourself, man, look how calm it is. Could be throwing topwater. But I'm gonna be throwing a jig. You know what kind of jig that is today? A tube jig, Strike King coffee tube. And, oh, look at that, when they take it, they take it. Gotta go down, bend, and that's out. There's the first fish of the day. But I can tell you right now, it won't be the last. It's not the biggest bass I ever caught, and it's not the smallest, but it's a bass, and it shows me I picked the right choice. Today, the coffee tube cast out, ripped in areas where there's bait fish, bait balls, and potentially more bass like this. Let's let them go. Ready? Go on. First thing in the morning, in the fall, you can take advantage of almost any way you want to catch them because they're on the feed bag, but just something about throwing that jig, whether it be a flipping jig, football jig, tube jig. For me, it's that power fishing. Doom, doom. I missed one. Another one was right there with the same fish, ate it. I'm gonna show you how I do it today so you can do it. You can have fun like I'm gonna have today. Let's go. You just caught a fish, you see lots on the sonar, stay off the trolling motor. Work a 360 around the boat, cast everywhere where you are, you know what I mean? Because why move? You know, you got fish right here, you see fish. I know that first thing in the mornings you get antsy, you wanna, oh, gotta keep finding those big ones. Trust the area you're in, catch what's there, use your gut instinct to tell you when to move. But for now, staying right here. Oh my God, look at all the streaks. They're all around the boat. Oh God, good one. Oh yeah, good one. Whoa, yes. Wow, right on the bottom. This boy was right on the bottom. Look at him shaking. Is he a nice bass or what? Look at that, hey. This one has to be netted. This one may go for a picture, hey. Look where he got it there. See that? That is an aggressive bite, boy. Just lift up and he is there. Just like walleye fishing. Oh God, these hooks. Oh, hold on, boy. Okay, this one's going in the box. I'm gonna put a few in the box. See if we can get some real good ones today and call out. Go on in there, just turn that on. There we go. Ripping the tube. Throw out, let it fall, watch semi-taunt. Watching it. The way they're biting first thing morning like this, you're gonna mostly feel it. A lot of times when it's settled on the bottom like that, give it a small rip, because they'll come over sometimes when it's on the bottom and go, pick it up, you won't even feel it. Even with those really good St. Croix, you won't even feel it. That's just how good they can eat. Let's get back at it. Another theme for the day is gonna be a little grub. You know, rage tails, different types, with a small jig head, thrown in the same areas, stay high in the water column, like I do for walleye, see if the smallmouth want it as well. Come on. That's it. That feels like a good one, boy. he's moving water down there. Let him play. Don't pull that hook out. I hit him again one more time just to make sure. Oh, what scrappy fish, boy. Scrappy fish. Look at the algae bloom. He's moving so much water down there, you can see it coming up. Staying down. Feels good. Just another solid fish. Look at him. Solid fish. On this, I only got 6 pound gamma. So I'm going to net these guys, because see how lethargic they are? Lethargic, man. Sure, they're eating and stuff, but they have this slow wobble fight, you know? Look what that is, just right on the corner of the lip. I'm going to put them in there, so I do not want to spook any fish. We'll get some, throw them back, let them go. It's all about just having confidence in the baits you use. You know, little rage tail, grubs, tubes, coffee tubes and stuff. And I want to, you know, not try to force the fish to come up to eat. Summer times, yeah, it's good. Yes, you're still going to get them now, but I want to keep catching fish all day long. So I picked a couple presentations. You know, the little grub, tube jig, and maybe the fish go real shallow. If I see activity in the shallows, pick up the stick worm and catch a few. But for now, I'm catching them here. I'm going to stay here. Let's keep going. Oh, I missed one there. God. I think he pulled it down. I'll bet you he pulled it down. Oh, yeah. Look at that. He pulled it down, folks. Another grub. I got a couple fish on that 3/16 jig head. I'm going to put that down and pick up. I got another one here rigged with a 1/8 ounce. Exact same setup, same jig, the whole deal, except 1/8 ounce. Stay a little higher in the water column and potentially see if I can get those fish that want to just suspend and not go down to eat it. Let's see if that's the case. Look how fast, eh? Boy, change up to a lighter tube. He was running at me, like right at me. I'd hardly catch up to him. Here he comes. Just a decent fish. Wow, he was up tight, man. Look how tough these fish are. Tough, man. Oh, he's a nice one too, look at that, eh? I'm going to have to net this one. Like I said, better safe than sorry, huh? There he is. Nice. Slightly lighter tube. I'll show you it. Right there. You know, 1/16 ounce. It's a real slow fall. And a decent little smallmouth. Felt like he's a lot bigger. We're going to let him go. And that's going to be a perfect reason for me to go to commercial break. Take off this. The sun feels like summer, and it's almost October. Okay, fish. Ready, set, bye. Stick around, we'll be right back on Extreme Angler TV, fishing for fall smallmouth with the tube jig.
Extreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
Hi guys, Andy Montgomery, Bassmaster Elite Series Pro. I'm gonna tell you a little bit today about a bladed jig. You know, it's one of my favorite baits. It's a very versatile bait. You can fish it kind of offshore, you can fish it around grass, you can fish it around docks, wood. It's a very versatile bait and it works year round. So, you know, this is something you really need to have in your arsenal. Basically, this is a white and chartreuse, but for the most part, I only use three colors. I use a green pumpkin, a black and blue, and a white and chartreuse. Depending on what the fish are feeding on, if you're feeding on crawdad or bream, then you need to go with the green pumpkin or black and blue. If you're fishing around shad, you know, then you need to go to the white and chartreuse. You can do a lot with the trailer. You know, you can change the trailer and really change the bait. Sometimes I like to put a caffeine shad on here. Sometimes I like to put the new swimming shiner on here. Something new I've been doing this year, and I've had a lot of success, is taking the rage bug and trimming it down. You can see how this is the regular rage bug, and you see how I just trimmed it down real streamlined. And these legs on the rage bug also give it a lot of action. So you can do the menace is good as a trailer. You can just put a lot of trailers on the pure poison and catch a lot of fish on a bait that's versatile. Like I say, you can fish it year round. Now that I've talked a little bit about the basic colors and stuff on the pure poison, I'm gonna show you a little bit about the technique on how you retrieve it and how you actually use it. When you're retrieving the pure poison, it's a pretty basic deal. You just throw it out and slowly wind it in. Every now and then I like to twitch my rod or just stop it just for a second, give it that little bit of erratic action, that little bit of different action. That's pretty standard retrieve. One thing I do is if you're fishing around grass is cast it out there, let it go down a little bit. And what you actually want to do is you actually want to run it into the grass, and then when it gets in the grass, rip it out. That's a deadly way in a big grass bed or in any grass to trigger that strike. When it hits the grass, boom, rip it out. And sometimes that will trigger a strike when the fish are not really wanting to feed. But for the most part, it's a pretty basic bait. You just throw it out, pretty medium speed, slow speed, retrieve, and you'll know it when he bites. He'll knock slack in the line.
Okay, here's what I'm doing. Real short underhand pitches. You know, maybe 30 feet, 40 feet ahead of the boat. Let it drop. I got that 1/8, 1/16th, little jig head, and that real shallow stuff, so it's got a fall. And I'm watching that bow in the line, tightening up, and a small little shot. Little rip, I call it, just to get their attention. So if they're swimming by somewhere else, they know there's a vibration, they see the bait, they see the flash, they come over, they eat it. This is all about fishing that stuff in front of you. You don't have to make long bomb casts. You're fishing those fish right in front of you. They're not far. You take your time, pitch out, let it fall, pay attention, keep your finger on the rod blank. You'll feel those little subtle bites. But sometimes it's been just lift up, there's ready to fish there, or that traditional tick, and then you know what to do. Set and have some fun. About that time. Oh, that's good smallmouth too. It's got some shoulders. You can tell by the way he's fighting now. Here he comes. That's a nice little bass right there. You ready for net yet? I think you are. Oh yeah. That's a fun little fish. Oh boy. Look how he's got it too. He's even got some weeds on his face too, huh? Look at that. That's a nice fish anywhere. And I'll show you something. Look where he got it there. Take a quick look. That's how some fish rip out. See where he's got it? See that hook there? It's just on that side there. And he's right on that. And that's how sometimes they come off. Because you just get that little skin. And it comes off. You can put him in a box for some pictures. But look at that. Just a beautiful Northern Ontario smallmouth bass. Long, lean, and tough. Just the way I like them. Let's put them in there for some pictures, huh? Then we'll let them go after. Shallow water, power fishing for smallmouth. That's what this is for me. All summer, 25, 30, 40 feet drop shotting, top water. This time of year, shallow and power. Jerk baits, spinner baits, tubes, you name it. In tight, heavy, ripping, jigging. These smallmouth run around like packed like wolves. 2, 3, 5, 10, sometimes 15 fish. Go in an area like Piranha, circle the fish, the bait fish, perch, chubs. But this time of year for me, especially in Ontario, I see a lot of perch. That is the number one forage these things are eating. So anything with a little bit of green, a little bit of orange flake, you know, different things that just offset, that makes them look like something they've been eating. But they travel in packs, moving around. So if you get an area, you're catching some fish, fantastic, stick it out. But when it slows down, keep moving, trolling motor on medium speed, keep finding fish. When you find weeds, 5, 6 feet of water, and you're not getting anything, move out slightly, move in tighter, because they're roaming somewhere looking for those meals, and you want to throw that little tube, they find it. One of them is going to try to eat it. Yeah. Oh boy. Oh boy. Just finished saying two, eh? On these points like this, that's where those big ones go. I'd say, whoa. What he saw, eh? He swam into there. Oh, man, they look so good when you hook them, eh? You think, oh, I got the record. But look at that. As close to a football you're ever going to find, man. Look where he got them, too. Right through there. Just through. Past the lip. Good spot, too. Because it's usually in. But look at that football. Just a perfect fall NFL football. Let's let him go here and just release, eh? Huh? You ready? Wow. Going again. Throw. Doom. Doom. Didn't feel the bite. Lift up. And luckily, sharp hooks. Doom. You got him. Then he just starts to go. This thing looks so real to them that I think they're just going up to it. Boom. Open their mouth. Eating it. Keep going. Having a fantastic day. Let's go. Smallmouth in the shallows. Gotta love it, man. And a nice fat fish, too. The ones you like to catch. Got that beef. Set hook and the rod just loads up. You know he's got some beef. Love it, man. You know, what is the key to me catching these fish? I'm going to tell you what the key is. Being patient, the right bait, rod, reel, everything, but slow fall. You know, most guys, quarter ounce, 3/16, they want to feel the bottom and stuff like that. That's fine. What I'm doing here, I see the fish all through the water column, and I'm fishing anywhere from 4 feet to about 12. I want that little bait to be in that water column as long as it can. When that tube jig goes down, it just slithers back and forth around. It hardly ever falls the same way twice. So when it's falling like that, even if it falls in the same area where the fish saw it, it's something different, you know, and just something that potentially could trigger them. And these smallmouth in the fall, they're feeding. You stay on them. Keep throwing a bait that's in their face long enough. They're going to try to eat it. Whoa. Six feet of water, and it's got some girth. What are you? It sure feels like a smallmouth. But there is pike here. Oh no, good smallmouth. Wow, eh? Around that edge, boys. Right on that edge. Right on the edge. 7 feet of water. Look how nice and thick. Oh, just a gorgeous fish. Gorgeous fish. Come here, boy. Look what he just spit out right there. Let's see what that is, huh? If I can bring that in there. Now I'll bet you dollars to donuts, that's a little perch. Dollars to donuts. We just netted two by catching one. You know why? I told you before what they're eating, right? Look at that. That's a little perch, boy. Yeah, look at the size too. Pretty close to my tube jig, right through the nose. Look at that. Wow. He would never come off. But look at that. Little smallmouth. We're gonna put him back right away. Ready, boy? I put you back, huh? Look at the camera. Kicking up. Let me show you this here. There's my tube, okay? There's the perch. Not too much difference. Only that thing's been regurgitated, but I mean, for the size, girth, you name it. That little tube is the deal. Makes it look real. They see it, boop, they eat it. 7 feet deep. Reeds and weeds. And you know what else is going to be in here, don't you? Yep. Mr. Smallmouth. Oh, I missed him, buddy. Missed him. And he came back. Do you believe that? Oh, look at him, too. Wow. That's how psychotic these smallmouth are. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Amazing. Felt the bite, missed him, tube jig drops, comes back and eats it. Wow. Or did he have buddies with him? Look how tough. I gotta chase him. Trolling motor's on 100. He's still pulling. Is he in the boat? Where is he, folks? It's in the net. Oh, just another beautiful, tough football. Football. Look at that tube jig. This tube jig has caught me some awesome, beautiful smallmouth bass. But I have had a fantastic day catching beautiful football-sized smallmouth bass in Ontario with a tube jig and a few on the grub. But it shows you, when the leaves change, the water gets cold, these guys go shallow. You got to get out here to Ontario and catch them. But what a day. But listen, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler, right here in fall in Ontario, catching all kinds of bass. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Let's go home.
Young Steels, Ford Lincoln, Interstate Batteries, CompuSolve, Top Gun Marine, Valley Fashions, Rage Tail Soft Baits. Catch us at ExtremeAnglerTV.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.